Hi, friends. It's Matthew Rodriguez here. And welcome to this week's episode of The World Of. Welcome to The World Of. Yes, ladies and gentlemen, we are light years away from last week's freaky look into the world of Zoomanity. Every week, we are releasing a new episode, so don't forget to subscribe so you don't miss it. Right now, we're taking flight for an out-of-this-world adventure where Cirque meets sci-fi in the world of Taruk, The First Flight. This touring show is, of course, inspired by James Cameron's record-breaking movie, Avatar. Taruk brings Pandora to life in a way you can never experience in a typical movie theater. The audience finds themselves in a riveting fusion of cutting-edge visuals, puppetry, and stagecraft, which all come together with a soaring cinematic score that is narrated by a Na'vi storyteller. And if you're thinking this is an Avatar remake, wrong. You are wrong. The mythical tale is set thousands of years before the events depicted in the film Avatar and before any humans ever set foot on Pandora. Now it's time for fun facts. 40 video projectors are used to create Pandora. The total projection surface is approximately 20,000 square feet, which is more than 5 times the size of an IMAX screen. 16 puppets represent the creatures of Pandora. 6 viper wolves, 3 dire horses, 3 ostrapedes, 1 tetrapede, 2 swarms of wood sprites, and 1 Taruk in a pear tree. While the viper wolves and dire horses are directly inspired by the movie Avatar, the ostrapedes and the tetrapede were created from scratch. The Taruk has a wingspan of 40 feet and weighs approximately 250 pounds. It is a reverse gravity puppet and brought to life by 6 puppeteers. The costume designers had to invent Pandora fibers that do not exist on Earth. Some varieties of flora used in the costumes are in reality cutouts of loofah sponge or molds from cabbage leaves. Others are made with parts of hammocks. Here's a fun fact for you. I don't have a tail, but I know someone who does. Welcome, Antonia. Thank you for coming all this way from the very far off Pandora. It must have been a long journey.
It was so far, it was all of the light years, and you know, I've aged.
You did. Well, you went back in time, I think. You went back in time. Tell us about being a part of Taruk. What does that mean for you as a performer and the whole experience?
Being on Taruk is actually quite great because as specialty performers, we don't often get the chance to try that many things outside of our specialty. So I'm normally a tissue specialist. An aerial silk specialist.
Okay.
But on the show, I do a bunch of ground acrobatics. It's a bit theatrical, so we get a chance to play with their character. And I'm also on a sort of high bar apparatus that I would normally never do in a show. But okay. I mean, it's...
So you've pushed yourself as a performer.
Yeah, because we're on stage for almost the entire show, running, and we're just participating.
Is that exhausting to be on the stage and not have a moment to go back?
It's it is tiring, but it's also... you end up with a bit of a different body than you normally would have.
Yeah.
Whereas, you know, as an aerialist, I look a bit like, I'm like Dorito shaped.
I actually
like have legs
term.
Now.
Is that a Pandora term?
It's not. I don't know. It's like an aerialist term because your shoulders end up like really wide and then it just gets smaller as you, because we don't use our legs that much. Obviously, we're just climbing most of the time.
And I've noticed you developed a tail. We've been talking and we haven't addressed that this is on your lap.
Yeah, so another thing we normally wouldn't have on other shows, we have tails on Pandora, which is interesting because it's they get in the way pretty often.
I would imagine. Is it difficult? Do they get snagged and get in your way?
Sometimes, but they're also very, very fun to play with.
Okay.
Because we have a bit of freedom when it comes to how we express as Na'vi on the show, because it's a community on Pandora, so every character is going to be a little bit different. It's like different personalities in the community.
Well, thank you so much for coming all this way.
It's been a pleasure.
And I'm taking the tail.
Okay.
Is that okay?
Yeah, it's fine.
All right. Thanks. I'm just gonna get out of here. One of our favorite acts from Taruk is an aerial silks act that takes its name from one of the clan groups in the world of Pandora, the Takami. The surreal aerialists weave themselves in bright pink silks, and it's just truly something to behold. Thank you. Get your steampunk outfits ready for next week's episode, where I'll take you through the spectacular Curios. Please do me a favor and share this video with all your Avatar-loving friends, and thanks for taking a trip to Pandora with me for Taruk, the First Flight. I'm wondering, can any of you at home speak Na'vi? Because I can't, and I would love for you to teach me. Let me know in the comments. All of the World of series are here, and you can check out lots of fun stuff in the description below. I'm Matthew Rodriguez. Remember to subscribe to Cirque du Soleil to flip your everyday reality the Cirque way, where everyone, every day, is extraordinary.